Authorities in the Philippine province of Aurora held a closed-door meeting as they prepare for the onslaught of Typhoon Rolly. Let's get an update on that from our correspondent, Rafael Bosano, joining us live from Baler. RAF signal number one is raised over the province. Are you already feeling the effect from the incoming typhoon?
Hi, Irene. As you can see behind me, the sun's up, the weather is hot, and everything seems to be normal for now. Now, the meeting between officials and the provincial government of Aurora ended shortly before 11 this morning on the preparations for the onslaught of Typhoon Rolly. Aurora Governor Jerry Noveras is particularly concerned about their access roads because heavy rainfall inevitably causes landslides. This is why the equipment of the DPWH is now pre-positioned and ready to remove any debris that may block the roads. Preemptive evacuation has not been ordered so far because, according to the governor, it has always been a challenge to convince residents to flee their homes when the weather remains in good condition. But he assured that tomorrow, forced evacuation will be enforced in low-lying areas. The pandemic has made it particularly hard for physical distancing to be observed in evacuation centers. The expected cold and wet weather will make it impossible for some families to observe distancing. Nonetheless, the governor says that they will make sure that evacuees will continue to be wearing masks even inside the evacuation centers. The province now has slated 69 COVID-19 cases from 4 municipalities. The local government also assured that there are enough supplies in the different municipalities. Now, we've covered different storms and typhoons in the past, and the reason people choose not to leave their homes is because of the fear that other people may enter and loot. But LGU says once they evacuate, the police will be watching over their homes to make sure that this doesn't happen. Rain.
Thank you so much for that report, Rafael Bosano.